Welcome to Referee POV. Today we're going to talk about referee signals. As a referee, you communicate with players, coaches, and spectators in three ways. Your voice, your signals, and your whistle. There are seven main signals that a referee uses in a game. Each of these signals can be used during a game to communicate either to the spectators or the players at any point in time without you having to say a single word. Signal one, direct free kick. When a player fouls another player and you need to award a direct free kick, you blow your whistle, stop, and point in the direction of the team that was fouled. Signal two, indirect free kick. When you award an indirect free kick, the proper signal is to put your arm straight up in the air. This is similar to an offside signal. Don't forget, on an indirect free kick, you need to blow your whistle before you signal. Signal three, goal kick. When the attacking team kicks the ball past the end line and it does not go in the goal, that results in a goal kick. The signal looks like this. There's no need to blow the whistle at that time. Signal four, corner kick. When the defending team kicks the ball over their own end line and it does not go into the goal, point to the corner flag to signal for a corner kick. Signal five, advantage. If an attacking player is fouled but they retain possession of the ball, simply signal for advantage. This indicates that you recognize there was a foul but are letting the team continue to play. You make this signal by either putting both arms or one arm out in front of you directly. Most referees like to shout, play on, or keep going to eliminate any confusion. Do not blow your whistle in this situation. Also, if advantage doesn't materialize, you can always pull the ball back and award a free kick to the player that was fouled. If a caution is warranted in this situation, wait until the play is finished, then issue the caution. Signal six, caution. When issuing a caution, you need to stand directly in front of the player, raise your hand, and issue the yellow card. Signal seven, penalty kick. When awarding a penalty kick, blow your whistle loudly and point to the penalty spot. As a new referee, you may feel overwhelmed with the amount of information you have to memorize. But when you break it down into simple steps, it's actually quite easy. Now, all you have to do is remember these seven signals and you're on your way to becoming a great referee. Thank you for watching today's video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to hit the like button. If you're looking for more videos on refereeing, make sure to subscribe. If you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll get back to you. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next video.